Hello on Saturday the 23rd of December. I know that some of you will be rushing around doing your final Christmas preparations, whilst others will be relaxed, pleased with themselves that everything is already prepared. And if you're travelling to visit friends and relatives today, I do hope that you all have a safe journey and don't encounter too many traffic jams. Our opening prayer. God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, whose mercies are new every day, at the start of this weekend leading up to Christmas Day, let the radiance of the Holy Spirit renew our lives, warm our hearts, give light to our minds, and help us to apply wisdom at all times. Amen. Today's readings are from Psalm 25, verses 3 to 9, and Malachi chapter 3, verses 1 to 4. Sometimes, when we're with friends, we find ourselves chatting about life at present, and then the conversation seamlessly develops into thinking about the future. We start to wonder what things will be like. One of these conversations happened when I was with a group of Christian friends. I wonder what it'll be like when we see God face to face, one of them challenged. Various in the group said that they would look God in the eyes. They'd make direct eye contact. And they thought that God would have very kind eyes. Now, when you look someone in the eyes, it tends to indicate that you have nothing whatsoever to hide. But others in the group thought that they would be unable to stand in the presence of our Almighty God, let alone looking in the eyes. The whole meeting for them would be completely overwhelming. I think that this second scenario is more in line with what the prophet Malachi says in today's reading. He poses the question, who can stand in God's presence? The prophet then goes on to say that the Lord is coming in order to purify and change us. He talks about how all the preparations for the Lord's coming are coming towards their completion. And the season of Advent is also nearing its end for us, that season of preparation. We are nearly at Christmas Day, when we celebrate Jesus' coming. However, this season of preparation is also about the Lord's second coming, and making sure that we are all prepared and ready for this, whenever it does take place. As this is my last social media post before this Christmas, our prayer for today is one linked to Christmas Day. Lord Jesus Christ, may we come to worship you with the shepherds, proclaim you with the angels, seek you with the wise men, offer ourselves to you with Mary and Joseph, and rejoice in your love. Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. For today's prayer points, let's pray for godly peace throughout the whole world. Pray for God's wisdom, and that it is sought whenever a decision is being made. And last but certainly not least, say thank you for Jesus, God coming to be with us. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. As I've already mentioned, we're nearly at the Christmas weekend, and so why not come to join us at one of our services over this period? So details of these services. Tomorrow, Christmas Eve at St. Aidan's, there will be a 9:30 service of Holy Communion, which will be live streamed as usual. And the 11 o'clock service will also include our Christingle. Then on Christmas Day, we have one service at 10:30, a family Holy Communion. On New Year's Eve, which is a week on Sunday, we will have our normal service times of 9:30 and 11 o'clock. If those service times aren't convenient for you, at St. Luke's, they will be on Sunday, Christmas Eve, at 4 p.m, holding their Christingle service. On Christmas Day, their morning service is again at 10:30, but I'm uncertain of the format of that. And then on New Year's Eve, the following Sunday, it is an 11 o'clock service. I just wish to mention that this will be the last social media post in this format until 2024. The filming crew are taking a well-deserved Christmas break, and we will be back on the 3rd of January. With that in mind, I want to wish you all a joyful and blessed Christmas time and a very happy New Year. And our blessing. May this Christmas time, may you know the peace and the joy of Jesus in your lives. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all and you.